Welcome everyone to Killer Instinct, my favorite game when I was growing up. Like, I guess Mario is up there, but I'm pretty sure if someone asked me what was my favorite game growing up, and as a child of the arcades more than the home consoles, it was Killer Instinct. Like, I don't know that Killer Instinct on the home consoles was amazing, but I fucking love this game. I thought it was an amazing fighting game, and anyone who says that Killer Instinct 1 wasn't good, I strongly disagree with them. Killer Instinct 2, though. Killer Instinct 2 wasn't that great. Killer Instinct 2 was actually probably a bad game. They made it... I think they tried to copy, like, the other fighting games, like Street Fighter, and it kind of went nowhere. Let's see. Let's just do random. I kind of want to pick one with the Sage Vitality, but anyway, Spinal was my favorite character when I was growing up. It was fucking awesome. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm not sure why I fell in love with Spinal. Like, maybe the other characters weren't doing it as much for me, but I don't know, just the way he did his combos and, like, his projectiles and everything else, I just thought was so cool. Here's Glacius. Probably looks better than he ever has. Like, look at this thing. Look at the effects on this thing. My computer isn't even that good. This looks incredible. Now, like, this is the one game where I almost bought an Xbox One for. Like, I was like, man, I really want this game, but it's like the only game I wanted the Xbox One for. I'm so happy that it eventually came out now for Windows 10. So, like, if you didn't know, this game is now available on PC. Insane combo, fuck. That is the best part. The sound effects, the fucking announcer, like, oh, it's so good. It's always been good. The original game, it was like this cool, like, movie. It was almost like, it was more a movie than it was a video game. With the level of production that it had, and it's just so great that it's, like, they got the sound effects so perfect. I'm not sure that the music is as good as it used to be. I still remember that killer track. Combo Breaker, fuck. Listen to that. So good. Like, I would say this game is definitely at least as good as the original game. And obviously way better than Killer Instinct 2, which was never that good. Oh, shit. I didn't realize it was the end of the match. Otherwise I would have tried to do an ultra. Supreme Victory. Fucking... They got everything so perfect. Like, I'm not sure if Iron Galaxy made everything perfect, because I remember playing a demo of it when Xbox first came out, that I didn't think they actually got the sound right, but right now it seems perfect. Like, everything seems perfect. Let's go through, like, all the characters real quick. There's Jago, who is, I guess, the Ryu of the original game. I never thought he was a star, but they treat him like he's a star. There's Saber Wolf. Cool fucking wolf. Glacius. Original guy. Like, most of season 1 is original guys, it looks like. Thunder. Actually, I'm not really sure if the top part... If the first line is all season 1, and then second line season 2, I'm not actually sure how it works out. Anyway, there's TJ Thunder, there's Shadow Jago. For some reason, you know why I basically bought the most expensive version of this game, but for some reason, there's still a guy that's locked, which is Shadow Jago. Like, there's also this guy down here, Omen, who I think is also Jago. It's like, I don't understand how Jago got so popular. Here's Orchid, who was maybe the star of the original. Like, I felt like she was the most recognizable of the original game. She did these cool spin kicks and shit. Spinal, my favorite character, of course. It's got Forgor, this robot. He's a cool guy, but he's kind of generic. Here's Aria, who I think is the boss of season 2, from what I gather. I don't recall who was in season 2, so I can't tell you who of these guys was in season 2. I'm assuming the people that are all generic are from season 2. TJ Combo, Mayo, maybe wasn't Killer Instinct 2, I mean. There's this weird guy, Kanra, who I don't think was in the original games. Maybe it was. This weird zombie guy. Riptor, probably one of the better characters. I was a huge fan of Jurassic Park growing up. There's this weird rock guy. Who seems very cool, but I don't know if he's from, like, a game. Like, I remember there was a game with a big rock guy. Maybe he's from that. I have no idea. Crazy horror, crazy shit. Alright, there's four... there's four characters down here that are from the new season. Here's Kim Woo, who was maybe from this Asian game a while back. I forget. Tusk, maybe from Killer Instinct 2. I don't think it's an original character. Here's Arbiter from Halo. Nothing more to say about that. He's from Halo. And then there's Battletoads guy, who is probably the coolest character, even though Arbiter is probably, you know, the draw of Season 3. It's so cool that he's in there. He's actually a really cool character. I think eventually they're going to have a Gears of War character too. But anyways, let's start another match. I'm not sure who else is going to get unlocked though. Well, let's go to Arbiter. Let's see this dude in action. The retro version of him. Oh, I have all the colors unlocked? Nice. Okay, super purple Arbiter. Let's find a stage fatality one. Even though I haven't showed you the... there's one stage fatality. Oh, this is pretty cool. There's a cooler one, but let's just do this one. Fight on. They have unlockable announcers. There's Aria as an announcer. It's basically this robot girl who talks very slowly and low. It's interesting. It's not cool, though. It's just interesting for a few games. And then you basically run back to this. They also have the original announcer, who I'm not really sure. I'm not really sure what is the big difference between the current announcer and the original announcer. I think it's the same person, so I'm not really sure. I think it's maybe fan service where people were complaining that the audio wasn't right, so they included the original guy. I know I was complaining, so I can understand what they did. I'm still trying to figure out like what I want to do with this channel. I kind of want to do more than just gaming content. I kind of want to try vlogs and shit. I mean, right now I've been sort of starting stuff and not necessarily finishing it. Like, the Mario game I kind of skipped, but the Mario game I actually got a copyright strike, so it made me less interested in recording at 10,000 videos. But in terms of Super Mario Maker, I know people want to see that. It's why my channel got somewhat popular. I wouldn't say really popular, because not a lot of people subscribe, but like, I do have one video that has like over 40,000 views. But I find that a lot of times I record videos and I'm not happy with how entertaining I've been. And by the way, there's been stuff that I've uploaded that I wasn't happy with. Okay, I'm trying to do the stage vitality. It's basically, you can see how it might unfold looking at, oh no. I'm just gonna do the motion for the stage fatality and I hope that it just works. There we go. Stage fatality!
Stage Ultra! Wrecked.
That's are so cool. He just says wrecked. Fucking Christ. This game is so cool. How can people that like this game now, as much as they do, not like the original game? The original game was just as fucking cool. I just don't understand. I think there's people that didn't really play the original game. They don't really understand what they're missing. But anyways, let's do something different. They also have a shadow mode. Shadow Lab, which is basically you basically make this character that is basically your shadow. It's supposed to fight like you. Right now my defense is shit. So like, I'm assuming my shadow can be easily beaten. But I don't expect a lot of people to play against my shadow. I think this is a mode that most people are gonna ignore. So like, I would actually be surprised if I ever get someone who challenges my shadow. Because the only way to randomly choose a character, basically the only way anyone would randomly fight my character is with shadow survival. I don't think anyone's gonna do that. I think most people would just go to challenge, short by price or short by rank, and then they just go through this and just randomly choose someone. So like, I don't really understand. I think this is an interesting mode in that like, I would rather fight against someone's shadow than the real selves, because the shadow version of themselves is unlikely to be a dick the way a lot of kids are. Alright, let's keep going. Riptor, Omen. Just pick a guy. I don't want to talk too much. Aria. Okay, let's fight against Aria. And let's find a really shitty shadow. Like a really shitty shadow. Now I use my shadow. But you actually fight it. You fight as yourself. Okay, I'm gonna do a random. If it's not a Sage Fatality one, I just do the Ultra. And I was saying that, like, I kind of want to try stuff like food reviews. I want to try like everything. Like, I don't want to just do gaming on this channel. I just want to make this like really fun channel for people to look at. And if I just do gaming, I'll be bored because like there's only so much you can see watching a video game. Eventually, you have to come up with something else. In my opinion. Oh no. That's bad. I'm fighting against someone's shitty shadow. I'm getting wrecked. Oh, and for some reason, Aria has 3 health bars. I don't know why, but obviously they're all smaller health bars. So it's... Oh my god! I was hoping that I could not try against this character. That's why Okay, I'm gonna pay attention. There we go. Just unnecessary damage. So I can do an insane combo. Okay, wait a minute. I have to figure out. I keep forgetting this stuff. My memory is so bad. Okay, so it's backwards kicks to do the ultra. I mean, this seems like a Sage that where you might have a Sage Fatality. Like, some of the Sage Fatalities are location specific. So it's possible I haven't been in the right location. Maybe the right location is in front of this furnace? I don't know. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm so bad. I'm so bad. The one time I tried online, no one showed up. It was stuck on waiting for. Okay, I have to do defense. This is not good. Really? He's... Come on. Jesus. Stop it. Jesus. No! What the hell? Why is this shitty shadow so good? God damn it! I didn't even realize she had this long projectile. I should have just fucking harassed her. So annoying. Best 2 out of 3. So I have another chance. Okay. Super tryhard mode. Let's go, guys. Oh, nope. That's not super tryhard mode. That's super shitty mode. Oh my god. I'm used to the AI just standing still, like never jumping like that. Like, what is this? I didn't know she could do these moves! Oh my god. Why is it so good? Why is this shitty... Why is it so good? It never beats anyone! Ah! Oh my god. He doesn't walk towards me, so I don't know what the fuck to do. Oh, once again, just perfect hits! It never... What is with this fucking game? This is not my favorite game right now. Like, seriously, why is this guy so good? Once again, I just fuck up a little bit. And it's like, completely fucks me up. I don't know. At least do an ultra. Oh, that was embarrassing. The world cannot rely on you. Supreme victory. All right. Well, my butt hurts a little bit. My defense is so bad in this game. I don't even know what to do. Yeah. Alright. Alright, guys. Well, Okay, I'll show you the story mode. There's currently not a story mode for season 3 yet. I don't know what they're planning on. But so they have season 1, which is basically kind of a shitty story mode, I would say. I mean, it does have intros and endings, so that's good. It's just it's kind of a contrived version of just fighting random characters with no boss. Where season 2 has a boss, and because of that, I think it's infinitely more interesting. I think the storylines are, well, the storyline is maybe not that as interesting, but it's a cool concept. So anyways, I'll try Glacius.
After 10 years in Special Forces, Ben Ferris decided it was time for a raise. So he went where the money is, corporate espionage. The only thing bigger than his ego was his talent. And before long, he landed a contract on the world's most powerful company.
So that's yeah, this Ben girl is, I think, the boss of every single Aria destroyed thing, Ben's but frail sure. body.
But even she could see that his skills were valuable. Ben was submitted to an experimental program called Project Cinder. Using alien DNA, Ben's genetic code was altered permanently, turning him into a being of pure, uncontrollable plasma energy. Aria constructed a suit that allows Ben to control his power and unleash it at will. Ultratech has improved on perfection, making Ben better in every way, and working for Aria allows him to show off his skills to the whole world.
They shouldn't call him Glacius, it should just be Ben. Ben. Yeah, and they have these little still images. I don't know, it's cool. Like, it's a very well-made game. I think, like, the original version of this game wasn't as cool, because it wasn't fully fleshed out. But, like, I think Iron Galaxy has done an amazing job with it. Props to Dave Land. Even though, dive kick is still kind of silly. It's interesting that you went from dive kick to this. It doesn't seem like a natural progression of events. Dude. Oh god. My defense is so bad. So bad. Okay, what happens if I do this with this guy? He just dies instantly. Good. Oh yeah. Just ran at me. But... Oh god. I wonder if there's a stage fatality on this stage. Okay, let's just try this. I'm just gonna play this one match and then we're done. This is going on a little bit too long. What is that ball? Oh, I detonated it, so... Yes. What the hell am I doing right now? Oh shit, I hate this, I hate her fucking super. I hate it. It's like, it's just this non-stop death. No! Don't! Okay, it's over. It's over. It's like, fuck. I hate that thing. This game is taking it easy on me right now. It's like, alright. I guess we'll, alright, I'm trying to do this. No, it's not working. And I'm gonna die. Really? I go from trying to do the ultra to dying? I think I was pressing the wrong direction. Fucking Christ. Alright guys, so that's Killer Instinct, my favorite game. Hopefully the audio is better this time around. I feel like the background audio might be kind of messed up, but alright, thanks a lot. And fuck me.